So good evening and welcome to chair, all the panelists and the participants. Myself Abhijit Giri. I work with Professor Sheikh Farooq Ali and Professor Arupya Rajan in Smart Material Characterization Lab and Vibrational Energy Harvesting and Control Lab at IIT Madras. In today's presentation, I will briefly review the asymmetric potential well-based piezoelectric harvesters and highlight some key facts about them. So my session outline is mentioned here. We'll start with a brief introduction to piezoelectric energy harvesting, followed by the evolution of harvesters. Then a generalized electromechanical model is presented, using which symmetric and asymmetric potential well-based piezoelectric harvesters can be simulated and analyzed. In the review of asymmetric potential well configurations, we have monostable, bistable, and tristable asymmetric potential configurations, following which dynamic asymmetries are discussed and introduced. Summary and conclusions are presented at the last. So as we know, vibration energy harvesting is scavenging the waste kinetic energy from natural or man-made outputs and converting them into usable electrical energy. Vibration energy harvesting has electrostatic, electromagnetic, piezoelectric, and latestly magnetoreceptive transduction modes. However, out of these, piezoelectric harvesting has highest density for power, highest density of harvested power. So research in this area is kind of promising. Potential energy harvesting applications are to the devices which are remotely located, such as wireless sensor nodes or electronic devices where frequent replacement of batteries is not feasible. On the right side, just a second. On the right side, we have two commonly used configurations of piezoelectric energy harvester. First one is the piezoelastic configuration, in which the piezoelectric layer is either deposited, or if it is in the composite form, is pasted using an epoxy adhesive to the substrate layer. In the second one, we use a tip and base magnets to impart the nonlinearity to the potential function and improve the broadband response of the configuration. So it is called piezo-magneto-elastic harvester. So the evolution of piezoelectric harvester is mentioned here. First, the materials are broadly classified as piezoceramics, in which we have barium titanate, PZT, natural single crystals, piezopolymers such as PVDF, and then piezocomposites such as recently we have these MFCs that we work with. And then we have firstly, the development started with the linear harvesters, in which the simple 1D model is used to represent it, and harvested power is measured using the dissipative power dissipated through the damping. Then the nonlinear monostable harvesters with some nonlinear attachment, introducing the nonlinear stiffness using the K3 here. K1 is your linear stiffness, and on top of that we have the additional K3. So what it does is, like, the resonance peak, which is at a particular frequency for linear harvesters, is now skewed over a broadband range in the nonlinear monostable harvesters. After that, we have this bistable, tristable, quadstable, and even pentastable harvesters are explored by the researchers. Recently, during the experimentations, we found that many of the results that we get are kind of asymmetric. So the influence of asymmetries on the various potential wells are also investigated by the researchers, which is also the topic for the today's talk. So we discuss here the generalized model, using which we can model both symmetric as well as asymmetric potential well-based harvesters. So the nonlinear restoring force is represented using the fifth order polynomial, which is like up to three stable positions we can model using that. Using the non-dimensional parameters listed here, we can convert it into a non-dimensional form. And then the non-dimensional stiffness is K1, K2, up to K5. Are also mentioned here. Using this model, we have modeled linear potential, nonlinear potential, which is of hardening type, softening type, then bistable potential and the effect of K3 parameter on the bistable potential. Then we have tristable and bistable potentials of equal depths in all the wells. Then we have a tristable potential, in which the depth of outermost potential wells is respectively higher and lower than the central well. And then we have modeled asymmetric monostable, asymmetric bistable, and asymmetric tristable potential wells. So the sources of asymmetries can be natural to the system or can be intentionally introduced. So asymmetries can be due to the transverse mechanical or magnetic loads, or there it could be due to the flaws in structure such as non-homogeneity or additional lump masses which are not balanced or kind of have an offset center of gravity. Asymmetric magnetic fields introduced intentionally by varying the spacing between base magnets, distance between tip and base magnets, and the uniform configurations. So these are like probable sources of the asymmetries that are introduced to the potential function. First, we start with the review of monostable and bistable asymmetric harvesters. Here we study the investigations by He and Dukak, which are presented earlier. A nonlinear restoring force in which quadratic nonlinearity coefficient lambda and cubic nonlinearity coefficient delta is used. Using this, we have modeled a linear case, the nonlinear case, the highest nonlinear asymmetric case, highest nonlinear asymmetric case, after which it will turn to the bistable cases. A bistable case, the red dashed line indicates a symmetric bistable case, and the root phi delta indicates highest degree of asymmetric bistable case. Coming to the performances of this under the Gaussian white noise, we see like at this point we have a linear harvester with delta equal to zero. So without any having lambda, what happens as lambda or the quadratic nonlinearity coefficient increases, it increases the average power output. Also, it increases the asymmetry as we have seen in these potential well diagrams. Delta, what it does is like it reduces the depth of the potential well and makes it a shallower. Also, it reduces the width. So as we see from the linear harvester, as the delta increases, the performance of the nonlinear symmetric monostable harvester decreases. At any delta value, if you increase the asymmetry, it will increase the performance of your asymmetric harvesters. If we choose an asymmetric parameter which is sufficiently higher, it may even be higher than the linear case. Coming to the bistable cases, so all the bistable cases up to an optimum delta value, the power output, which is normalized with the excitation strength, for the low excitation intensities, it increases up to an optimum delta value. This happens because as the delta increases, as we said earlier, the potential will become shallower, the interval transitions are promoted, so the power output also increases. But as we can see here, after the optimum delta value, the power output decreases. This is because further increase in delta reduces the RMS displacement of these configurations, so the power output also decreases. We see here that red color line belongs to the symmetric bistable case and it has the highest power output. The black color line belongs to the asymmetric monostable harvester, which is like lower than the symmetric harvester. And the bistable case with the highest degree of asymmetry, it at lower delta values, its performance is lower than symmetric bistable as well as asymmetric monostable harvester. But at higher delta values, the performance is comparable. So this was under the low excitation intensities. At higher excitation intensities, all of the harvesters show the same trend. So we can conclude that at higher excitation intensities, influence of asymmetry vanishes. Next, similar study we have from Mr. Kumar et al. We have a comparison of linear case and then asymmetric monostable case with a symmetric bistable case. So the power output and the induced strain levels were compared here. We can see here in this for a band limited white excitation noise of strength 0.005 PSD, the solid lines represent the power output and the dashed line represents the induced strain levels here. So at the low excitation levels, the asymmetric harvester is able to generate more power than the bistable case. Similarly, the strain levels are also lower in asymmetric monostable case than the bistable case. We can see here that at the excitation, lowest excitation intensity, the asymmetric potential is able to execute the interval oscillations, but the bistable case is not able to do so. To generate the similar amount of power, the asymmetric bistable case needs an higher excitation level of 0.02. Also, with the varying load resistance study, we see that the asymmetric monostable case gives the highest power output. Moving on to the tristable case, an interesting study has been presented by Zhou and Zhou. Using the harmonic balance solutions for the asymmetric tristable case, they tried to compare various configuration. So the four important barriers, like barrier 1, 2, 3, 4, as we move from left to right of the potential wells, were designated. Here, what happens is, like, according to the highest barrier, case 1, case 2, and case 4 are the asymmetric tristable harvesters, and case 3 itself alone is a symmetric tristable harvesters. So it was shown that the barrier which has the highest depth of barrier attains the high amplitude response at a higher amplitude of the excitation. Also, it attains it for the very low bandwidth. So it is straightforward. Since it has the highest barrier, it attains at the higher amplitude of the excitation. Similar thing goes with the green colored asymmetric harvester. Now, between case 4 and case 3, which is like asymmetric, case 4 is asymmetric tristable and case 3 is symmetric tristable, we can see that even if the case 4 has the higher barrier than the case 3, which is symmetric, the next barrier of the barrier number 3 of the case 4 is lower than the symmetric tristable. That's why that is the reason case 4 is able to attain the high amplitude solution at a lower amplitude. So this study shows that the highest barrier has also impact on when it will attain the high amplitude solution. Also, the second highest barrier also has impact, like whether it will attain high amplitude solution or not. Moving on to the next cases, case 4 here is similar to what we have here, which is an asymmetric tristable case. Case 5 is a symmetric tristable case, and case 6 is again symmetric tristable case. So between case 4 and case 5, the sum of the barriers, barrier number 2 and 3 of the symmetric case, is equal to the sum of the barriers of case number 2 and 3. So what it means is, like, both barriers, both these cases have equal sum of barriers for barrier number 2 and barrier number 3. So despite the fact that the asymmetric distribution of barriers attains the high amplitude solution earlier than the case 5, as we can see it from this case. Also, between case 6 and case 4, here the last barrier, comparison of last barrier is presented here. Even if the last barrier of case 4 is smaller than the case 6, since the case 6 has the other barriers lower than the first barrier, it attains the higher amplitude solution at a lower excitation intensities. So kind of interesting facts are presented, like how to position the barriers. Also, it was mentioned, like, the X2 and X4, the unstable equilibrium positions, if they are modeled closer to the trivial equilibrium position, the barrier depths will be increased and it will promote the interval oscillations. Further, we introduced the dynamic asymmetries. So what are the dynamic asymmetries? So let us consider this configuration. When the harvester configuration is at rest, that means it is not under any excitation, the potential well function is symmetric. So during operation, what happens? So this study was for a bistable harvester under human walking and running motion. So what happens during the sway motion of the leg, the gravitational forces on the tip mass will cause the bistable potential to to do a seesaw motion, which is like a time dependent. So for the negative sway angles, it will tilt on the one side, and the pause, when the leg moves to the positive sway angles, it will move to the right side. So due to this, what happens, hopping between the potential was improved. We have seen earlier, like asymmetric bistable potential has the lowest response than the symmetric bistable as well as asymmetric bonus table. But in this case, due to this swaying motion, the hopping of the oscillations happen. And also, like we see, like here, there is comparison between linear case and asymmetric bistable case. So kind of there is a formation of virtual dynamic equilibrium at the center, and also the response of the asymmetric bistable case is higher here. So the sway motion not only provides the excitation but also provides the modulation of the potential well here. So gaining idea from this fact, the similar group has what it does for the configurations which are not experiencing any such forces during its operation. They have introduced a tilt angle phi, which they call it as a bias angle, to nullify the asymmetries and improve the performance of the bistable harvesters. So another case is like a stochastic excitation is also there, in which like noise intensity excites, gives you the main excitation, and the periodic excitation gives the modulation. But here we have to consume, but in the stochastic case, we have to consume the energy for giving the periodic force, which will modulate the potential well. But here the sway motion does both the jobs. So seems kind of efficient than the other methods. Similarly, we have, so coming to the conclusions, we can conclude like that asymmetries improve the performance of monostable harvesters. Also the strain levels, induced strain levels in asymmetric monostables are lower than the symmetric bistable harvesters. So the asymmetric bistable case has the lowest performance than the symmetric case, and at higher excitation levels, the influence of asymmetries deteriorates. We have seen that for the multistable harvesters like bistable, tristable, quadstable, the potential well which has equal sizes for all the potential wells marks the best performance. However, if you do the asymmetric distribution of these potential barriers, it will increase its probability to do the interval oscillations. Next, the dynamic asymmetries improve the low excitation performance of the asymmetric bistable wells, as we have seen from the previous studies. So these are some selected references that we have mentioned. Thank you for your attention. These and many studies have been reviewed in our recently published review paper. So we would like to have comments of you.